Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining the different types of VPNs. When you hear about VPNs, what most often may come to mind is a subscription-based service that's designed to keep your connections and online transactions safe. But what does that VPN service really deliver? And is it the only type of VPN that's out there? Well, these services are actually just one kind of VPN, and they deliver something very specific. There are other types of VPNs as well. In this video, we'll be examining the different types of VPNs that are out there and what each type is actually used for. If you want to take a look at the fundamental operation of VPNs to understand how they work, please take a look at my related video that's linked in the description below. A virtual private network, or VPN, is a technology that creates a private and secure connection between two endpoints over an inherently less secure network, such as the internet. A VPN is essentially used to allow users to transmit their data in such a way so that even if a malicious user were able to intercept that data in some way, it would be undecipherable and thus useless. As a result, confidentiality is maintained. So what are the different types of VPNs? Now, what determines what type of VPN you're really using depends on what devices are actually functioning as the VPN endpoints. There are four fundamental types of VPNs in this sense. We have commercial VPN services, site-to-site VPNs, remote access VPNs, and browser-based VPNs, which is actually a special case. Now, each of these serves a slightly different purpose, and we'll examine each one briefly. Let's first take a look at commercial VPN services. Commercial VPN services are those that deliver encryption and tunneling between your end device and a server that the VPN service provider maintains. Typically, for a monthly subscription fee, you can connect your PC or mobile device using the service's software that you download and install to any one of their servers that they may maintain worldwide. Now imagine you're browsing a web page using a VPN service. The VPN endpoints in this case are your device and the VPN server. The green path here shows the traversal of the encrypted data. Once that encrypted packet reaches the VPN server, it's decrypted and sent along its way to the web server. Note that the packet is secure only between your device and the VPN server. It is no longer encrypted between the VPN server and the web server. The benefits here are twofold. First of all, your communication from your device onto the internet is hidden from your own ISP, and it's also hidden from any prying eyes on your local network, whether that's a corporate LAN, a coffee shop Wi-Fi network, or your home network. This ensures that the data sent through this green path is encrypted and secure. Secondly, the VPN server actually acts as a proxy server. So the packet that reaches the web server actually has the source IP address of the VPN server, your original IP address and thus your physical location, and other attributes that you can determine from an IP address are hidden from the web server itself. Now, when it comes to site-to-site VPNs, the VPN endpoints change. A site-to-site VPN will use network devices such as routers or firewalls to perform the role of the VPN endpoint. This allows two remote networks, such as branch offices, for example, to be connected to each other as if they were on the same physical network. I've added little clouds here, labeled local LAN, to emphasize the fact that all devices on each local LAN can communicate with all devices on the other LAN securely through that VPN. Note that in this scenario, there's no subscription service involved. You simply configure the VPN on the devices at each site. Now, when we come to remote access VPNs, in this scenario, the VPN endpoint exists within the user device. In the diagram, we see PC1 here as a VPN endpoint using a VPN client. This endpoint connects securely via a VPN server or VPN device at the remote site. In this case, that device is a router, but it could be a firewall or some internet-facing VPN server. This allows the PC to connect to the remote network and enjoy the same privileges as a PC that is physically connected at the remote site. Remote access VPNs are very useful for a mobile network, where users can connect to the corporate network from their homes or from their mobile devices, and they can access network services that are only available to internally connected devices. Now, in this scenario, like the site-to-site VPN, it does not require a subscription service. You can use VPN software available from your Windows, Mac, or Linux OS, and you can configure your VPN server on the other end on your own device, whether that's a router, a firewall, or some computer system. And finally, we come to our browser-based VPNs. Now, as the name suggests, they operate within the confines of a web browser. In this case, the actual end devices involved are the browser itself and the web service on the web server to which it connects. Browser-based VPNs are designed to encrypt only web traffic, and their scope is limited to the activities performed within the browser itself. And actually, they're often limited within the scope of a specific website. So if you connect, for example, to your banking site, a VPN connection is created between your browser and the web banking service that your bank provides. You know you're actually using a browser-based VPN when you see the HTTPS in the address bar. Most browser-based VPNs are associated with a protocol called Secure Sockets Layer, or SSL, which is a term that you most likely have heard of. So these are the types of VPNs that you can have based on where the actual endpoint of the VPN tunnel is terminated. Now, there are many technologies that achieve tunneling and encryption for VPNs, and we talk about those in another video. You can find a link to that one in the description below. As always, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other topics related to VPNs and security, feel free to let me know in the comments. And please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.